Hey, good afternoon to one and all. My name is Sai Kumar. I will lead ground improvement techniques. Okay, this is the one of the elective subject which was prescribed by University of JNTU. So that in the ground improvement technique is a totally elective subject which is related to both geotechnical engineering and engineering geology. Both are related to this elective subject, such that those both engineering geology and geotechnical engineering are both are main subject. This is the application of those two main subjects. That means some of the important principles which are useful in our daily life for such kind of projects. So that in those projects, this subject is mainly useful for prevent accidents. Okay, for preventing accidents, these main principles are useful in a big projects and other important structural parameters. So that we have to discuss about these ground improvement techniques. This ground improvement techniques totally comprises of 6 chapters. In the first chapter itself, we need to learn these in situ densification methods. That means in-site densification method. In the term itself, we are having in situ densification. That means we need to densify the particular amount of soil. That means in a particular area of field, we need to densify in those field by using different geotechnical methods or ground improvement methods, different kinds of equipments and different kinds of solvents which are related to chemicals, chemistry. So that all those are useful to densify the particular soil in a different area, such that we are having a different topographical parameters according to topographical parameters and environmental conditions and temperature conditions. All those are effects due to different parameters on that particular soil structure and strata. So that we need to consider all those and we have to choose a particular method which is suitable for those place. So that these ground improvement techniques are vary with place to place and soil to soil, such that we need to adopt a proper method. In the first chapter, we will discuss densification methods. That means densification means simply we need to improve the density of particular soil by using different additive materials. Okay, we will introduce the subject, the need of this ground improvement. That means in our day-to-day life, what is the need to this ground improvement? As more and more land becomes subjected to urban and industrial development, that means we are getting urbanization. That means huge amount of industries and other upcoming structures are coming to particular places. So that urbanization is going on and industrial development is takes place in our country. In the olden days, we are having a huge amount of fields. So in such a time, we are having only agriculture is the main source of income. But after the industrialization, huge amount of industries are coming to our country and our state, such that there may be an industrial development also in pharma or any other or mechanics. That means huge amount of cars and other industries are coming to our state, so just there may be a industrial development also in our country and state also, such that good construction site and borrow areas are difficult to find on the That means a good construction sites. That means the site which are having construction features as much as possible are and borrow areas. That means those two lands are not sufficient in all conditions. In few of the places we are having a huge amount of water. In few places we are not having water. That means there may be a tight position. If a industry is constructing, means there may be definitely need of water. Without water and any other needs, daily needs. There is no industrialization, such that we have to use proper natural resources available on those particular area, so that the construction sites and borrow areas are difficult to find. In all places we won't have these features, such that soil improvement is alternative becomes to best option for technically and economically, such that which places we are not having a huge amount of soil, we need to go there. That means in some of the places we are having huge amount of soil, but we are having not having natural resources. But in some of the places we are having plenty of natural resources, but soil strata is so weak. In such places we need to choose particular amount of soil, and we need to densify the soil by using different geotechnical methods and ground improvement methods. Okay, we have a plenty of land in our country, so that we have to utilize in a proper manner, such that we have to use for industrial constructions and other urbanizations, etc. The main features where a project encounters difficult foundation conditions, possible alternative solutions are, that means a project, that means for our engineering people, the project means mainly a construction work. Encounters means a difficult foundation conditions, that means encounters means we are facing a particular problem, such that difficult foundation conditions, that means for every project or any structure, the foundation is a major one, because the entire load will be transferred through foundation to the soil, so that if the foundation is as strong as possible, the project will be as withstand for huge amount of years, and we need to save a good number of projects with these foundation conditions and others. So that the alternative solutions for a good project are, first one, avoid the particular site and relocate and plan highway design and development site. That means whatever the site we are having obstructions for constructional project, so that we need to avoid, particularly in the first condition. That means first of all we have to check the particular area, if the area is fully with problems, so that we need to vacate that area and we have to choose another place to go for our project. That is the main theme of first point. And second point we are having is the design the planned structure accordingly. Some of the many possible approaches are to, that means design the planned structure accordingly. That means we have to plan a particular structure accordingly. We need to go for possible approaches. That means in all ways we are not getting a solution, such that we need to go for a particular way, so that we have to go and solve the problem. In those we are having use a raft foundation supported by piles. That means nowadays we are using this raft foundation for a lot of structures, so that the structural strength will be increases due to these raft foundations and others. And we are using supported by piles. That means piles means normally in geotechnical engineering too, we have studied these piles and others. That means piles are normally constructed to a huge foundations to have a more amount of friction with the soil. Normally like our bridges and other constructional projects, we are having these pile foundations, so that the bridge has to bear huge amount of loads. That means we are having vehicular loads in terms of tons and others. That means for each and every vehicle which are going in a national highways and other roadways, we are having a capacity of 20 tons and 30 tons, such that those loads will be carried by these elements of the bridge, such that we need to design by these pile foundations. So we won't have these raft foundation for bridges, because the raft foundation means on a particular area we have to design the foundation with the help of the solid slab like elements, so that the slab will not bear the total load. In case we have to go for these pile foundations for different structures having those have to bear huge amount of soil bearing capacities and others. In the second one point, we are having design a very stiff structure which is not damaged by settlement. That means settlement means whenever the load applies on a particular element, the element will have to settle due to its application of load. That means if we compress a particular column, that means in the columns normally we are having compressive loads, beams we are having tensile loads, like that different elements having different load conditions, such that due to application of those loads on particular elements, they have a smaller change due to those loads and they have to settle for that particular loads. That is called as a settlement. Various structures, that means many of the structures are up bearing different loads, and due to those loads they will settle a particular amount. That means you know, points percentages they have to settle, such that we have to design a particular structure with maximum stiffness value. This stiffness term you studied in structural analysis, stiffness factor for different kinds of elements with different conditions, like both ends are fixed, both ends are hinged, one end is fixed, one end is roller supports, like that we are having different end conditions, such that we are having stiffness value varies with these end conditions and other structural parameters involved in the structure, such that we need to design a very stiff structure without any settlement. This is the main meaning of this point. Next one, we have to choose a very flexible construction which accommodates differential movements or allows the compensation. That means we need to choose a flexible construction. What is flexible? Flexible means whenever we apply a particular amount of load, the structure will have to bend. After the removal of the load, the structure will have to regain its position or structural size, such that those are called flexible structures. Normally flexible structures we won't have exist in our real life, so that we have to design accordingly. Normally high rise structures are not so flexible. To flexible structures are with a short span and a limited height, so that we won't have to go for high rise buildings with flexible construction. Whenever there is a small structure, those small structures can be designed with flexible construction properties with the proper compactions and compensations. Those are related to the second structure. And the next third point is mainly remove and replace unsuitable soils. Remove and replace. Remove means the top layer will be removed up to some content where there is a unusable matter and unavoidable matter. We need to remove those materials by using different equipments like cranes, proclines and others. And we have to replace unsuitable soils. That means we have to replace with industrial wastes and other important unimportant wastes coming from the industries, such that those things we have to use here, and we need to strengthen the particular soil. And third one, in those we are having removing organic topsoil. Whenever we are having a organic or any other peat material in the top layers, there will be a different settlement in those particular structure, such that we need to remove those organic matter. What is organic means? Simply the matter which will be decayed under sunlight and water. Those things are called as organic matters, such that if there is a tree, the roots will be absorbed this organic matter, such that in a few days or few years the total place will be having huge amount of voids due to absorbing of these trees and other vegetative matter which are having on the top layers, so that these matter will not be useful for the construction. We have to remove the organic matter whichever is present in the particular area, so that the soil will be strengthened. And volumetrically unstable, that means whatever the material we are having with volumetrically unstable, those things we have to remove on particular stage because of these conditions. So of whenever there is a organic matter, definitely there will be a rising of plants and other vegetative matter in the particular site. Those vegetative matter will cause a disturbance to the foundation. If there is a tree nearby the structure, that means the roots will be absorbed into the structure. Automatically there may be a cracks forming on the structure. normally we are seeing in our near places, few amount of trees are కొన్ని కొన్ని చెట్లు అనేవి మనకి స్ట్రక్చర్స్ మీద వస్తూ ఉంటాయి. వాటి వల్ల మనకి ఏమవుతుందంటే ఫర్దర్గా ఆ స్ట్రక్చర్ మొత్తం కూడా డిమాలిష్ అయిపోయి స్ట్రక్చర్ మొత్తం కూడా మనం పడేయాల్సిన స్టేజ్ వస్తుంది. డ్యూ టు దీస్ ఆర్గానిక్ మ్యాటర్స్ దోస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ సిచ్యువేషన్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఫేస్ ఇన్ అవర్ రియల్ లైఫ్, సో దట్ వీ నీడ్ టు రిమూవ్ దిస్ ఆర్గానిక్ అండ్ అన్యూజబుల్ మ్యాటర్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఫార్మింగ్ ఆన్ ద టాప్ లేయర్స్ ఆఫ్ ద సాయిల్. అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ పాయింట్ ఈస్ ద దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ స్టాండర్డ్ ప్రికాషన్ ఇన్ రోడ్ ఆర్ ఫౌండేషన్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్. దట్ మీన్స్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద పాయింట్ వీఆర్ డిస్కస్డ్ ఇన్ ద అబౌవ్ దట్ ఈస్ అ స్టాండర్డ్ పాయింట్. దట్ మీన్స్ స్టాండర్డ్ ప్రికాషన్. ప్రికాషన్ మీన్స్ వెన్ ఎవర్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు డూ ఏ పర్టికులర్ వర్క్ దీస్ ప్రికాషన్స్ ఆర్ యూస్ఫుల్ ఫర్ ఎ గుడ్ ఎకనామిక్ కండిషన్. దట్ మీన్స్ ఎకనామిక్ కండిషన్ మీన్స్ వీఆర్ లేయింగ్ ఎ పర్టికులర్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ రోడ్ వితౌట్ దీస్ టాప్ లేయర్ రిమూవింగ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఫ్యూ ఇయర్స్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు గో ఫర్ reconstructing of particular road because of availability of these unusable organic matter, so that our project will be reconstructed with a huge amount of money loss. So that we need to use these standard precautions while we are constructing a particular road like materials and other foundation like constructions. Next one we are having attempt to modify the existing ground. That means attempt to modify the existing ground, whatever the ground existed before construction of a particular project, we need to avoid. That means modify. What is meant by modify means we need to do for a particular problem we are getting a wrong answer. That means we need to modify some amount of data such that we need to get a particular proper answer. So, likely whenever there is a site with unusable soils and other organic matters on a top level, we need to modify the soil parameters. That means we have to simply lay the top layers. That means we have to lay those top layers with the help of different mechanical equipments and other. In some cases the area is very small in condition. That means normally man power is useful to remove the top layers. If the area is so large, likely we have to use these mechanical power. That means bulldozers and trucks and other cranes like that. We have to use the mechanical operators and we need to remove the top layer. And we have to fill this with stable and inert materials. That means inert materials means those who are not react with other substances, those are called as inert materials. Because of filling with inert materials means there will be a huge amount of stability to the structure such that the structure will withstand for a lifespan without any obstructions and failures and other conditions we won't have to face for everlasting time. These are the main points. First one we are having is avoid the particular site. That means completely avoiding, we have to go for another site. Second point we are having is we need to plan a structure accordingly. Some small approaches we need to find. Third point we are having is we have to remove and replace unsuitable soils. Fourth one, we have to modify the existing ground. That means we need to modify some structural parameters and functional parameters. Next one we are having is what is the objective of this ground improvement technique. Objective means normally in the laboratories we have some objective to do the projects. That means small scale of projects and large scale of projects we are doing in these laboratories, so that we have a particular objective. What we have to do, what is our objective, by using those approach what we have to find, such that in the ground improvement technique also we are having some objective. The most common traditional objectives include improvement of the soil and ground for use of foundation and or construction material. That means the soil will be used as foundation or construction materials with the help of these improvements. That means the soil strata and other parameters will be changes according to our construction, such that we are
doing a water structures. That means the soil will be filled with normally top layers will be with the help of these stone dust and others, because if there is no chance to erode the top layers, such that if the top layer is eroded, automatically the total structure will be having huge amount of loss. So that we have to go for according to our project situation and conditions of the soils. Next one, the typical engineering objectives for this ground improvement techniques are: first one, increase the shear strength, durability, stiffness and stability. Normally this shear strength will be act along horizontal axis, compressibility axis along vertical axis. So that shear strength means normally at a particular horizontal axis, means we are having this ground level is a horizontal to our structures, so that the shear strength will be acts on the particular structures. We need to increase the shear strength and durability properties. What is that durability means? There are so many kinds of external parameters which are acting on the structures. Due to those external parameters, our structural health may be delayed and decomposed due to these parameters. So that we need to avoid those parameters to improve our durability properties. And next one is the stiffness. That means if there is any external force which was acting on the structure will have particular amount of stiffness. Normally this stiffness is denoted with the letter K. And stability. Stability means there is no change of position due to external application. Stiffness means a proper value for the structure. Second one, we are having mitigating undesirable properties. That means undesirable properties. There is a dampness coming on the structures due to these rain and other external parameters. Normally for few apartments and houses after constructing few years, that means 3 to 5 years, we are having top layer of the structure will be eroded and the paint will be demolished. In such kind places we are observing the total top paintings and other coatings. That means the coating means mortar coatings all will be demolished due to this action of wind and water, so that they were having some dampness. Those are called as these undesirable properties. Those are shrink. Shrink means normally there will be a change in the dimension. Those are called shrink. Swelling potential. Swelling means automatically ubbadam manaki. There will be increment of volume. That is called swelling potential. Next one, compressibility, liquibility. Compressibility means acting towards the center with a huge amount of force. That is called compressibility. Next one, we are having liquibility. Liquibility means due to the action of water, the total structure will go down due to this liquefactions and liquibility techniques. And the third point, we are having modifying permeability, the rate of fluid flow through the medium and others. That means modifying permeability. What is meant by permeability? Permeability means whenever a layer is permeable, means the water will be entered as easily as possible through that particular materials. So that those are called permeable materials. If the water is not entering to the particular material, that is impermeable. That means water anedi manaki plastics kunda normal ga water anedi flow avadu. Plastics are impermeable. Normally soils having permeable nature, so that water will permeable onto the soils up to some limit. After that the soil will stagger on the particular ground level due to excess of this water content. Next, fourth one, we are having improving efficiency and productivity by using methods that save time and expense. That means improving efficiency and productivity using different methods. We have to find out different methods. All those are not found in a single day or single year. Those have to, those methods will be implemented along with the different ideas by the innovators who are working on those particular methods in the research areas. Like our so many faculty members are doing their doctorates with different contents in their PhD thesis books, so that those are useful to these different conditions and others to improve the soil properties. In some cases they have to improve the structural parameters. In some cases they have to use different techniques involved in the construction and easy transportations and other navigation principles others are related to these techniques and innovations. Next one is the determination of how best to achieve the desired goals is required for providing a workable solution for each project has been encountered. That means for a different kinds of projects, we are having a different principles of construction. Whether the project will be small scale or large scale or medium scale, we have to check. That means if the project is associated with a huge amount of money, that is a large scale project. If the project having small amount of money and medium amount of money for constructing and completion, those are related to money matter. So that we need to innovate. For suppose we have to construct a particular dam, that is a large scale project. For that construction of dam, we have to require huge amount of materials and manpower and other equipments for carrying and building, like shattering work and other reinforcing work and other things are likely we have to do in a different manners. For that, these ground improvement methods have provided adverse choice or approaches for solving these challenges. For constructing a dam like project, so first of all, we need to choose a particular area. If the area is having different soil parameters, we have to check those soil parameters are suitable for the site or not. Is there any modifications required for those soil parameters? What is the full scale of level of water is there in a particular dam? What is the soil condition we have? What is the bursting force acting on the dam? For the particular bursting force, the dam withstand in how many days? What is the minimum amount of height required for that particular dam? All those things we need to associate, and we have to find out the proper values for that particular project. Those all things are related to this geotechnical parameters and ground improvement methods. Next one, what are the factors affecting the choice of improvement method? That means before going to construct a particular project, we have to choose the appropriate method by considering different parameters, so that we need to improve accordingly by using these parameters. First one we have to choose is the soil type. We are having a different kinds of soils: black cotton soil, red soils, alluvial soils, soft soils, clay soils, silt soils. Likely we are having different kinds of soil according to their topography and place we are living, so that we are having a particular project on this particular area, those soils are useful for that project. If we construct that project on a particular site, how many days it will withstand? It is a cheaper project or heavier project for those soils. What are the preventive measures we have to take? If the preventive measures we are taking is how much cost they are having, so that the total project will withstand or not for those money. All those things we need to having relation with this soil type. Next one is the area. That means how much amount of area we have and what is the minimum area required, maximum area required. It is sufficient or not for the particular construction work. All those things we need to remember. Next one is the desired or required properties. What are the desirable properties? Those things will be given in IGBC, Indian Geotechnical Parameters chapters. Those things have to taken from those. What are the minimum values required for particular projects? What type of values we are having? How we have to modify those soil properties by using different densification methods and geotechnical methods. All those are associated. And next one is the availability of material. This is a major key role in a particular project. This will be availability of material. If the material means normally we are constructing a house. For the construction of house, normally we have a particular amount of cement. After that, we have to use sand, water, and bricks, tiles. Majorly, we are using steel as reinforcement. After that, we have to require these shutterings. After, we have to use this labor. All those are easily available, or anything required is not. That means మనకన్నీ కూడా చీప్లో దొరుకుతున్నాయా లేవా. ఇఫ్ దెర్ ఈజ్ ఎనీ నెసెసిటీ ఆర్ ఎనీ టైటింగ్ పొజిషన్, దట్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్లేసెస్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ శాండ్ యాజ్ ఎ టైట్ మెటీరియల్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ప్లెంటీ ఆఫ్ kilometers we have to go for the sand. Likely we are having any material obstruction for particular project. All those are comes under this availability of material. In some of the places we are not having this human power. Particularly in foreign countries, they are not having a particular human power because of they are not having particular population. In those all population are having education, no one work as a labor, so that they have to use these robots and other mechanized equipments for pumping and laying of these slabs and other important construction works. So that availability of materials also we are having human power also. Next one is availability of skills. That means we have to construct a particular amount of slab, so that we have a bar bender. After that we have shuttering man. After that we are having daily wage labor. After that we are having a prescribed site engineer. All those persons are useful for the construction of a particular project. They are having different sorts of skills. So that means a labor having different sorts of skill in grinding the material, and a site engineer having different sorts of instructions. How much depth we have to lay, what is the minimum thickness we required, what is the minimum diameter of the steel we have to provide, all those are necessary for the construction or not. And a shuttering man, these shuttering men are useful for the shuttering purpose of particular slab. Likely different parameters and different cultures of persons are associated with the project, so that all those are comes under this availability of the skills. Next one, environmental concerns. That means in the environment itself we are having a different kinds of features. Normally in summer seasons we are having huge amount of atmosphere temperature. In winter season we are having a low temperatures, but in case of rainy seasons that is not suitable for the construction purpose. Likely we are having different kinds of environmental concerns according to the different topographical features. In Himalayas we are having the nearly cold temperature, that means below 20 degrees or 30 degrees we are having temperatures, and in some points we are having less than 10 degrees also. Like that we are having different features. In Tamil Nadu we are having huge of humidity, but in case of Orissa and Rajasthan likely areas we are having different atmosphere in environmental problems. According to those problems we need to go for our construction work by mitigation by measures. That means we have to use different kinds of mitigation measures according to the temperature and environmental issues. Next one is economics. This economics means mainly related to money matter. We are having a particular amount of money. By using those particular amount of money, we need to complete our total project with a short span of time, so that we have to use those material and manpower and money power using, and we have to complete the project such that our project will be possible. Otherwise the total project will be delayed due to some unconditioned effects due to this economical and others. These are the main factors for using these improvement techniques. Next one, major factor is the soil type. This is the one of the most important parameter that will control the approach of the material. Will be applicable only in certain types of soils and grain sizes. Soils and grain sizes. These grain sizes are mainly related with D10, D20, D30, D40. That means the diameter of the particle varies with 10, 20, 30, 40, like in microns and mm's. So that those grain sizes are denoted with these D10 and others. Certain types of soil types, like previously we discussed, black cotton soils, red soils, alluvial soils, morum soils, sandy soils, clay soils, silty soils, different kinds of soils we are studying in geotechnical engineering. All those are associated with these soil types. And the area, and depth and location of the treatment required. That means depth. They are implementing this ground improvement technique. At what depth we have to use this condition, and what location we have to treat. It means in a particular part of the structure, at what location we have to treat the structure. And next one, many ground improvement measures are having different depth limitations to render the unsuitable applications for the deeper soil horizons. That means for deeper soils, the soils which are having less particle size and other parameters, so that those are not suitable for this area criteria. Next one, we are having undesirable soil properties. undesirable and required soil properties. That means obviously we are having a different methods are useful to achieve different engineering properties. To obtain methods which will be provided various levels with uniformity and improved sites. That means different methods we are here implementing to strengthen the soil parameters and soil properties for our constructional work and according to our project work. This is the main theme. Next one is the availability of material. The detail also previously discussed, depending upon the location of our project, materials required for each feasible ground improvement techniques we have to approach. That means normally ground improvement techniques means mainly we are having different chemical additives and other fibers, likely those kind of materials are available in a particular area or not, or we need to import from any area. Those things are comes under this availability of materials. Availability of skills, that means local experience and local preference, while the engineer may possess the knowledge on understanding a preferred method. That means if there is a preferred method, we need to go for grouting techniques. That means grouting is one of the ground improvement technique. For the grouting technique, we have a strong labor. That means they have to face a huge amount of force, so that with the help of this force, they have to inject some amount of cement paste with high force on a particular soil strata, so that we have availability of the skills. How much length we have to maintain, how much angle we have to maintain from the particular soil level, you know, what span we have to spray for a particular area of the size, so that all those are comes under this availability skills. Next one, we are having environmental concerns. That means a better understanding and greater awareness of particular effects on the natural environment. That means what time we are constructing the particular project. In this particular time, what is the temperature levels regularly maintaining? Is it suitable for construction or not? Those things we have to know. Those things we will remember according to our experience and other external parameters which were located on the site. So that we have to main focus our attention what time we are working, it is a preferable time or not. We have to use to some environmental impacts also. That means any seismic activities or any other tornadoes or wind effects are there in the particular site. All those we have to concern regarding to these environmental parameters. The last one we are having is economics. That means economics means else have been considered that final decision of the choice improvement method will be come down to ultimate cost of a particular method. That means what materials we are buying, is those suitable for our construction work or not, how much cost they are having, the cost is superior or inferior to our project. Those things we need to remember before going to buy those projects and materials. Deciding factor for choosing between two or more otherwise suitable measures. That means if you go for one material, the material gets the particular strength for that project. That means we need to observe two or more materials giving same strength, so that in those two or three materials, what is the cheapest material and what will be the cost of that particular material. Those things we have to compare and use by using this economics. And next one is the second major point, major topic is identifying your soil type. Soils can be identified in general types. They are having a feel and a respond to the handling. That means whenever we are touching that particular amount of soil with our hand, we need to feel whether the soil having which properties, whether it is a granular soil or silty soil, clayey soil, what amount of properties they are having. All those can be identified when we touch the soil strata, whether it is a sandy soil, if this is bulking or any other properties are there in a particular soil. All those can be identified while we handling those soils with our hands, so that we are easily how to access the quantity of soil and properties of soils. That is discussed here, pick it up with a handful and squeeze two together. That means we have to take a particular handful material
హ్యాండ్ఫుల్ మెటీరియల్ మీన్స్ మన చేతికి వచ్చే మెటీరియల్స్ మొత్తం కూడా మనం అనేది ఆ సాయిల్ నుంచి ఎక్స్ట్రాక్ట్ చేసి స్క్వీజ్, దట్ మీన్స్ దాన్ని బాగా గట్టిగా స్క్వీజ్ చేయాలి, అంటే గట్టిగా నలపాలి మనం. అప్పుడు మనకి ఏమవుతుందంటే ద సాయిల్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ విల్ బి అబ్జర్వ్డ్, ద సాయిల్ ఈజ్ టుగెదర్, శాండ్ ఫీల్స్ గ్రిట్టీ అండ్ అదర్ గ్రెయిన్స్ నో స్టిక్ టుగెదర్. దట్ మీన్స్ మనకి శాండ్ని బాగా ఎంత ప్రెస్ చేసినా కూడా మనకి ఆ శాండ్లో ఉన్నటువంటి పార్టికల్స్ మధ్య బాండింగ్ అనేది ప్రాపర్గా ఉండదు, దే విల్ రిమూవ్స్, దట్ మీన్స్ దెర్ ఈజ్ నో ప్రాపర్ బాండింగ్ బిట్వీన్ సాయిల్ పార్టికల్స్. అదే లైక్లీ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ లోమ్ ఫీల్స్ వెల్టీ ఫ్లోర్ లైక్ వెన్ వీ డ్రై అండ్ ఫార్మ్స్ ఏ వీక్ బాల్ షేప్ వెట్ స్క్రంబుల్స్ అపార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ ద డ్రై. దట్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ సమ్ ఆఫ్ ద సాయిల్స్ దట్ మీన్స్ దోర్ కాల్డ్ లోమ్ వెన్ వీ మేక్ లైక్ ఏ స్మాల్ బబుల్స్, దట్ మీన్స్ స్మాల్ ఆఫ్ డయామీటర్ బబుల్స్, సో దట్ దే విల్ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ ఏ బాల్ షేప్డ్ అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ద క్రింప్లింగ్ దే విల్ హ్యావింగ్ నాట్ ఫోకసింగ్ పర్టికులర్ బైండింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్, దట్ మీన్స్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ హ్యావింగ్ ప్రాపర్ బైండింగ్ ప్రాపర్టీస్ వెన్ వీ క్రంబుల్ దోస్ అండ్ దే విల్ డివైడ్ అపార్ట్ ఫ్రమ్ దోస్ ఈచ్ అదర్. లైక్లీ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ డిఫరెంట్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ సాయిల్స్ హ్యావింగ్ డిఫరెంట్ ప్రాపర్టీస్, వీ నీడ్ టు అబ్జర్వ్ వైల్ వీఆర్ ఫేసింగ్ ది సాయిల్ స్టేటస్ అండ్ అదర్స్.